Desire is not wrong. What we desire and how we act on our desires is what can get us in trouble. Desiring another man's wife is wrong. Desiring a closer relationship with God is right. Desiring sex isn't wrong. Acting on that desire outside the covenant of marriage is. Wanting to remain a virgin until marriage is good, but even that is not the main point. Author Lisa Velthaus explains, making virginity the point results in various how far will you go scenarios with dozens of different people in which you may or may not be breaking your pledge of sexual abstinence, but you're also not living under God's larger call to something greater and sweeter. It is only when purity becomes our central focus that God's vision for sexuality becomes clear, a cause for celebration, and a call to obedience. There's a big difference between lust and love. Lust is defined as intense sexual desire. It focuses on looks and the body and on sex for personal pleasure. Love focuses on character and sex in the covenant of marriage as mutual giving. Lust is fantasy. It does not discuss deep feelings. Love is real. It's difficult and sacrificial, dealing with deep emotions. Lust is selfish. Love is selfless. In Greek mythology, Homer wrote about Odysseus and the sirens of the sea. The sirens were dangerous creatures whose voices were tempting to humans. Odysseus ordered all the men in his boat to stuff their ears with cotton so they wouldn't hear the sirens' call. But he even went above and beyond, having his men tie him to the mast of the boat so he would be anchored to it and not able to follow after the dangerous temptation of the sirens. Lust is powerful. He had a plan in place to avoid falling for temptation. Odysseus thought ahead. We might not have a time machine like a DeLorean to travel into the future, but we still need to think ahead about the consequences of our decisions. What if you knew you weren't going to marry that boyfriend or girlfriend? Would you still sleep together? If you knew that someone would get hurt by what you shared as gossip, would you still say it? If you knew posting something online would negatively affect your ability to get into college or get the job you've always wanted, would you still post it? God wants us to think about our actions because purity isn't simply about what we do with our bodies. It's about what our hearts look like. Odysseus was anchored to his boat. What are you anchored to?